glad to join this learning session. I would like to tell about the law of NHRIs in empowering children human rights defenders. I have a PowerPoint. Okay, thank you very much. I will tell about as a national human rights institution, the National Human Rights Commission of Thailand. I will call NHRCT plays a crucial role in promoting and protecting human rights for all sectors of society. The NHRCT emphasizes the importance of children and youth as both holders of rights, who must protect, and as human rights defenders who advocate for their own rights and issues. The NHRCT strives to improve children and youth understanding and engagement in all aspects of its work, including human rights promotion, protection, and monitoring. Number one, human rights promotion. The NHRCT developed its strategic plan to raise awareness of all sectors of society on the importance of human rights, which strategy one, to promote and follow up on all sectors of society to respect human rights. Strategy two, to prevent and address systemic human rights problems. Strategy three, to establish cooperation of its network organizations, both domestically and internationally. Strategy four, to increase knowledge, understanding, and awareness of the realization of human rights. And then the NHRCT developed a variety of programs tailored to each target group, particularly the human rights education program for children and youth. The next slide, the development of handbook on human rights curriculum for primary education level and higher education level. This is a sample. And then the establishment of human rights education and coordination centers across regions, aiming at promoting and supporting local academic institutions as the dependencies of the community to promote human rights and address human rights violation. The next slide, the regional human rights education and coordination centers have carried out various activities designed for Hon Kang University and Liberties of Eastern Thai have experienced difficulty in accessing public information. The awareness raising through various forms of media and channels, such as radio broadcasting, print media, human rights journal, and public relations media. The photo and short video clip, do you know? TikTok contest as a part of the Youth Standing Up for Human Rights project, which aims to enable youth learning of human rights within the context of Thai society to social media platform. This is a poster for human life for all. It's the next slide. Yeah, for example, human life for all. Yeah, and then Thailand has experienced a situation in which children and youth have participated in political demonstrations since 2020. As a result, the NHRCT recognized the necessity of fostering civil and politicalized knowledge and comprehension. The NHRCT is now working on online learning material on the subject of the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights in collaboration with the Finnish Norman Foundation of for Freedom. Thailand has experience. Okay, the NHRCT has discussed the possibility of forming a partnership with UNICEF Thailand, Chiefs of Child Protection Program, to work on domestic child rights issues, such as developing a complaint mechanism for children and youth, promoting understanding of the optional protocol to the Convention on the Rights of the Child on a Communications Procedure, child rights in a business and human rights context, and disseminating General Comment Number 25 on children's rights in the digital environment. The next slide. Number two, monitoring and assessing human rights situation in Thailand. The NHRCT is responsible for monitoring and assessing Thailand's human rights condition. The NHRCT will prepare an annual report on Thailand's human rights condition, including recommendations for the Cabinet and National Assembly. The report will also be made public in order to truly promote and preserve human rights, as well as to encourage state agencies to honor, protect, and fulfill their human rights commitments. The NHRCT monitor political demonstrations in which many children and youth participate from 2020 to 2021. The NHRCT visited the protest site to witness the demonstrations and hear the facts from all parties involved. We discovered a number of instances where crowd control police uses violent tactics. In addition, some demonstrators under the age of 18 were detained by the police. This causes certain groups to be concerned about the safety of children and youth participating in demonstrations. As a result, the NHRCT issued recommendations urging the government to ensure that crowd control tactics and consistent with international norms and child rights principles. In the event of a political demonstrations, protesters use a social media platform such as Facebook and Twitter to campaign their agenda and schedule the protest and to accuse and defame their opponent. This involved the dissemination of false information and several demonstrators who were under the age of 18 have been arrested and charged. The NHRCT has closely monitored the situation. Recommendations were directed to authorities concerned, including the Prime Minister and the Commission General of the Royal Thai Police, requesting them to comply with the human rights standards in their activities. A number of public statements were also issued to encourage all parties to adhere to human rights principles. According to detained, the NHRCT has coordinated with relevant agencies to prevent human rights. The NHRCT, for example, negotiated for the release of children on bail, paid visits to youth detainees, and urged police officials to uphold human rights principles, particularly the rights of children. The NHRCT then hosted a forum with representatives from various government agencies, human rights organizations, the media academic psychologists, as well as Chilean and Jews on the lives of the shy and the situation of political assemblies. The NHRCT has made the following recommendations to relevant agencies based on the principle outlined in the Convention on the Rights of the Shy, to which Thailand is a party and has obligation to comply. There should be a public forum specifically organized for children and youth who join protests. Government agencies should have appropriate guideline and procedure for treating children and youth in assembly areas. Government officials should provide appropriate preventive measures to guarantee the safe exercise of freedom of assembly, and should separately treat violent from non-violent protesters. The Royal Thai Police should provide training for crowd control officers in performing their duty in accordance with international standards, with clear guidelines and the dimension of children and youth. The government should arrange coordination between the Ministry of Digital Economy and Society and the Royal Thai Police to safeguard, protect, and prevent the dissemination of personal information of children under the age of 18. It should also include measures to prevent stigmatization, bullying, and hatred incitement in the online world by people with different opinions. Afterward, the NHRCT organized a meeting with relevant agencies, including the Royal Thai Police, Ministry of Justice, Ministry of Social Development and Human Security, Office of the Court of Justice, and Office of the Attorney General. To follow up on the recommendations, the NHRCT proposed that all collaborating agency creates a safe space where children and youth can exercise their rights and engage in constructive conversation. In addition, the discussion yields direction for all parties to coordinate in order to safeguard freedom of assembly, the protection of shy protesters, and the life of children in criminal justice. Finish. Thank you very much.